Start recording. Beautiful. All right, let's get this. What is it? Fall Guys vs. Spike Virgin. Hopefully one of the miners captains is thinking on their feet and actually going to make a group because I'm doing other things. If you happen to keep listening, my tag, if you're in here, make a group, I'd appreciate it. What are we going to do on the scoreboard here? Fall Guys. Touch that. And then we gotta do this. All right, we're in business. We are in business. Spike Aversion versus Ball Guys. Now, I promised iTag if it starts to be a bit of a mauling, I'd play Who Let the Dogs Out. So maybe we might see a bit of that. No one is yet to PM me with a group. This is annoying. Fine, I'll just link them this group that I'm currently in. Actually, no, I'll make a new one. Why is life so hard? We are starting off on Transilio 7 quadruple 6. Give me some competitive settings. No overtime, because that's disgusting. We'll do a put BGs on red. Spike a Virgin on blue. Where is the Nigel? Twelve minutes. Apparently I've been told 12 minutes from iTag. Maybe that's because I'm early and I can't count the time, or because they've agreed to delay, that's fine. I'll get the replays working. I'll get the replays from last game up on stream. Give me maybe 2 minutes and that'll be all sorted. You can wallow in all the goodness of the hundreds of caps that played earlier. Well, you'll have to miss out on the last one. Actually, no, I can just copy it instead. Genius. And then if we come in already, we can see that he went. And we do this. Oh, what? Pesky old dog. Alright, now they're kind of setting up for these pops here. But Timmy's going to get ahead too. Nice bomb here. Nuka's got Mumby blocked out. And Boom. Boom's got the other one. He's got the pop as well. And that's the first cap coming in for the BBC. Scoreboard at the end of the halves as to avoid inundating myself. And iTag's going to come through the gate with some good gate there. Good button by someone. Second cap there. 2-1 quick. They've cost themselves a couple of caps. But here we go. This double tag pro is in effect. Oh! Was that Timmy? Beautiful boost. Beautiful. And now he's going to get a chance to cap on his own. The third cap for the BBC. Oh my god. Again. Okay, they kill themselves to it. It's just Mumby to beat. Oh, okay, boost a delay, but it's not enough. Diggs will come and get the first one for the second wave. Chris trying to rush out with the Juke Juice to beat them, but couldn't. The snipe on Timmy too. Gets his own return. And the kiss. I mean, he's got a juice here. Bombs out bottom with it. Diggs got the block on as well, and that's going to be ahead of everyone, unless iTag has anything to say about it, which he doesn't. And they're the first to get on the scoreboard the second wave, bring it back to a one-cap ball. The OD's okay. iTag makes a last-ditch grab and saves the cap there. Timmy cannot get out, but they've saved the cap. Ooh, a TP each here. Nuka kisses, and that's it. 3-3, second wave. They've leveled up this game fairly quickly. Another tag pro. This is real tag pro hours out here. Mumby trying to gun for the kiss. You gotta go for it. Mihi is going to get the shutdown. Timmy can't quite time the bomb down. And they're going to head into the lead here. It's a pretty brash grab from Timmy there. They looked indecisive of how they were going to try and navigate around that RB. Now Dig just has to beat Mumby. And with the Juke Juice, he probably would do that pretty easily. Fifth cap coming on the board. They're now leading by two. It's kind of falling apart here for the BBC. Crisp's coming in as well, but the OD is there with four of them. But no anti to stop this re-grab train. Diggs gonna come under. The grab, not enough to save, but Nuga ends up getting the shutdown, and that's the sixth cap. Mumby and Crisp in this probably a pivotal 1v1. Crisp gets the grab, Mumby gets the TP. No, he doesn't get the TP. Oh boy. Second wave, and Chris just boosts straight in. That must have been a very good come-to-come straight bot there. He just did it without question. Interesting. Boom, waiting as long as possible to defuse that bomb there. Chris won't get out. Diggs gets a nice little rub-off there as the return comes. Got a chance to go under Timmy, and he does already. Beautiful. Barbie and a juice. Kind of just going to see a lot of circles going on. Ooh, there's a moment of chance for a cap, and Timmy does pull that one through. Well bombed. It'll strike back for the BBC. They're definitely not going to want to throw this game away for free. Possible. Gets underneath Chris, but misses the flag tile. Ooh, I think Boom should have scored that. Oh boy. Now there's two flashes coming in. Chris got that neutral. And he uses it to great effect. Get that second cap. They're moving into the side channels, but I mean, we're seeing them move out of base even when they're not in a channel. Mumby with a nice little bump grab. He's going to come out red. Good block from Timmy and Boom. Mumby comes around the back to even things up. Right before the pulse spawns too. Timmy with good RB usage to get iTag out. Steams up red around Diggs. But Anuga's there to cover. Chris with a... Well, that's not a good flaccid. Timmy punishes those. Around the back, good blocks from the OD, and BBC will take the lead. Bombs up now. Oh, and he goes for it. I love that route. That was a good one. Nearly had it working. And the blocks are under the Force Flaccids from Nooga's play there. Means it's only 2 on OD and the 3 BBC back in. But Meehee there gets kissed. Good kiss there. No more RB for you. The 3 OD is swarming and they do it well. Mumby Flaccids though. Luckily iTag's in an alright spot. Nothing too dire going on. Hopefully I get that replay in time. Ooh, I thought Timmy had that bump grab. Gets it anyways. Out left with the team boost. Bounces over Diggs and under Nooga with a nice little block from Boom. And Boom stopped Diggs there. Straight away. Timmy stopped Diggs there. Straight away. Timmy's having a big game. And Crisp as well. Oh my lord. No, sorry, iTag, I meant to say there. Two quick caps and me here. We'll get the counter. Alright. Let's calm down. Diggs, we'll grab and get out. That probably alleviates a lot of the pressure going on in their base at the moment. Good anti from me here. Diggs is just playing around with Boom for a bit and the return comes in the bottom corner. 6-0. Chris gets the solo return with the help of the bomb. iTag steaming out and around, and Diggs, who was on the pub, and the other guys didn't really stay ahead, didn't do Diggs any favors. And he'll get that into overdrive in this half. iTag kind of playing patient. He here, and Nooga with two fucking brutal solos. Mumby can't quite make that boost to stop the cap. 7-7. Crisp runs it in. iTag, oh, he had the push. The RB doesn't do anyone any favors. Oh, beautiful bomb block from Nooga to get Boom out of the way. And the cap comes in straight there. Diggs with another rub grab. The rub grabs are probably coming a little too easy for the second wave. And, yeah, that's another cap. It's an okay kiss. Dangerous, but they gotta get the caps. The return is not coming. Crisp is safe. It's just gonna be a little, I was gonna say a little reset, but it's not. Crisp comes in for the 10th cap. We're into double digits, so Meehee will get it. Well, I thought it was gonna grow flag pro for half a second there. Alright, here comes the grab. Mumby with a. Oh, I thought it was going to get that straight line solo between the TP. Here he is. They're just storming straight up. 11th cat. And it's a few minutes for the BBC. Biggs out to the right here. Get the team boost. Goes under Mumby. Perfectly hits that to roll straight on with the spin. Beautiful cat from Biggs. Only to run into me here. Was conveniently placed at the bottom. Crisp with an RB on flag. Oh, they're just going to push through again. He doesn't even defuse himself. What a god, Crisp. Oh my god. First block from Nooga. Boom is there, but they just have to keep Flaccid to stay alive. Boom probably didn't have to Flaccid there. The three people would have been a cap anyways. That's the 10 bagger. 10 bagger for the half. Whew. The 10 bagger. 10 bagger for the half. Whew. This is very brutal stuff. Oh, iTag. Nice cap there. Probably shouldn't have let him take the boost, but gets around the people who let him take it anyways. Can only juke what's in front of you. Now they're kind of setting up for these pops here. But Timmy's going to get ahead of two with a nice bomb here. Nooga's got Mumby blocked out and Boom. Just a quick little update. We're just waiting on iTag to get back from being AFK. His team is making his way into the group though, so we should get the game started. But I'll keep these replays rolling for you. Good gate there. Good button by someone. Second cap there. 2-1 quick. They've cost themselves a couple of caps. But here we go. This double tag pro is in effect. Oh, was that Timmy? Beautiful boost. Beautiful. And now he's going to get a chance to cap on his own. The third cap for the BBC. Oh, my God. Again. Okay, they kill themselves to it. It's just Mumby to beat. Oh, okay, boost of delay, but it's not enough. Diggs will come and get the first one for the second wave. Crisp trying to rush out with the Duke Juice to beat them, but couldn't. The snipe on Timmy, too. Gets his own return. And the kiss. And he's got a juice here. Bombs out bottom with it. Diggs got the block on as well, and that's going to be ahead of everyone, unless iTag has anything to say about it, which he doesn't. And they're the first to get on the scoreboard the second wave, bring it back to a one-cap ball. The OD's okay. iTag makes a last-ditch grab and saves the cap there. Timmy cannot get out, but they've saved the cap. Ooh, a TP each here. Nuga kisses, and that's it. 3-3, second wave. They've lopped up this game fairly quickly. Another tag pro. This is real tag pro hours out here. Mumby trying to gun for the kiss. You gotta go for it. Mihi is gonna get the shutdown. Timmy can't quite time the bomb down. And they're gonna head into the lead here. Pretty brash grab from Timmy there. They looked indecisive of how they were gonna trade. Alrighty, the teams look like they're about to get ready, so sorry to ruin your replay experience. But we got a game of Tag Pro. It's a stream. Ball Guys and Spike a Virgin. Ooh. Quickly fix up that scoreboard. Wait, why is that? I am the big dumb. Alright, the teams are ready. On one side, we have iTag, Legback Duke, Strange Cloud, and JJ. Strange Cloud playing under the name Junkanoo. And then we have Nigel, Only One Nut, Doors, and someone who I didn't actually quite see, so forgive me. But you will see them very soon. Give me a refresh for good luck. I want these logos on the screen. Three, nice and pretty.
Two, one.
Oh, one more. We won't miss anything important. God damn. It's not working for me tonight. But regardless, here we are. I have some inside information. Apparently iTag is going to be playing defense on one of the maps. But not Transilio, apparently, as he gets out bottom. No doors of the clutch gay in the end. Deju playing around the portals. iTag's here already to help, so if they want the handoff is threatening. He gets out anyways, out top. Ridgy stays alive long enough. It was a flaccid. Only One Nut. It was an exciting prospect, actually. I've been excited to see how Only One Nut plays because he's been playing amazing in RPGs. And I think he's really going to help. Spike a Virgin. Already. Kind of looks a level above with his holding, although that doesn't really show there. And iTag comes in, first cap for Ball Guys. Ooh boy, I hope it does not become a blowout, but I have a feeling it might be. JJ's got the TP. Not slowing down to kill doors. iTag's probably begging him for it. Gets around and gets the grab anyways. Could be his ahead of three here. They just need to get the return now. Strange Cloud and Laidback Duke do the job. And cap number two for Ball Guys. iTag. Two caps, 1.5 minutes. I'm getting concerned. Doors there. Nice little portal play. Got a bit of space to work with, but Strange will get the return. And Ridgy doesn't look like he's going to make it anywhere either. So the pups are going to spawn. We'll see if the teams have any preset plans on which pups they should be stacking. Jeju's already sitting on that left pup. Oh, he sees his position. Nigel will end up with a RB. One not with an RB as well, but Strange with a juice. Okay, they're just giving Jeju a lot of space to play with that boost. One not will bomb out though. Which is, and goes for the kiss. Probably didn't go for it. Ended up doing it anyways. Doors. Some slick jukes. Not enough. Alright, the game slowed down a little now. Jeju with the top bomb grab. Just doors to get around. He's holding his side though. No, he's not. Jeju out top. Runs into the wall though. Slows him down and dies. Nigel's got the bomb out here. Ooh. Couldn't quite make it through the gate, but Laidback had the button snipe. Oh, one nut. Splits LBJ and Strange Cloud is out bottom. There's no bomb here, but he's ahead of two. Doors has a TP, but Strange Cloud had to hit that snipe and did. That would have been a disaster had that snipe missed. There's a beautiful little juke there from one nut. They got another chance here. Doors could probably just kill and go. Doesn't matter if his flag pro is going to run out. Gets one kill. And he gets the block. LBJ is a little behind. No. Well played. Strange Cloud. No. Doors kind of bombs out well there. And now is ahead of three with Anti coming in from one nut. Oh, I'm not quite sure why Doors decided to go up there. There was a path into base if he just kept going straight. JG's going to grab and probably alleviate a bit of pressure. Oh, LBJ could be baited into a bad grab here, but one nut combos the boost and knocks out the Kintay. Once a beat here, iTag's going to beat down on Ridgie, but Ridgie uses the portals effectively. Still danger. One nut's coming in with the RB. The boosts are taken out. He'll get an RB grab here with the bomb, and who knows, pressure might swing back. Oh, oh my god, it's all happening. Nigel gets back in time to save it. Strange Cloud out ahead with the boost. Runs into LBJ, but gets a third cap for the ball, guys. Oh, my lord. This game's too quick for me. There's so much going on. Jeju off the corner boost with a grab. Can he make Doors look silly? No, he can't. Ridgie gets shut down as well. Bloody hell. I tag. Where's he gone? Maybe a lag refresh. It's like, I don't have five caps already. I must be lagging. Need a refresh. Pups are up. Two in mid for Spiker Virgin. My tag's maybe lagging out again. Maybe they need a sub for him. Maybe he's checking if Steam's downloading. That's probably like the number one tip if you're lagging. You gotta check Steam. Doors on the portal though. Gets out. That's ahead of four. Oh, LBJ clutch snipe. He didn't actually touch him, but he made it so the boost that Doors had to hit was ridiculous, and he couldn't quite do it. Bloody hell. One nut. A nice portal out through the gate, but there's two people to beat, and he probably can't do it. So we'll see how these teams set up with like an extended hold. They're playing one midfield, three OD. The ball, guys. See, this is definitely a universe where, like, they're only three caps down, and if iTag's not able to play, Squidder the substitute, by the way, I think is definitely underappreciated in the Miners League. Like, this is definitely a winnable game for Spiker Virgin. I mean, it always is the whole time, but, you know, when iTag's out, who's, you know, really the big player. Two TPs and an RB do not sound very good for this franchise, but it is an amazing capping situation if they can get through a turn, but they can't. A good kiss from Strange Cloud, I believe that was. And that denies them a cap. Oh boy. Hey, yeah, your true belt, look. There's two theories I have on JO. You know, people say that they believe only one nut is what, testicles, but could be JO. Like, JO either left Tag Pro to become One Nut, or he like ran off with Gracie J. I don't know what's the deal. Anyways, pop battles. RB, two RBs, three RBs. They're probably all going to be defused, but Jeju's got to grab. I don't know, Nigel's undefused. Kind of wishes that One Nut would die sooner or later. Surely you got to be calling for the drop ASAP when you got RB. Oh, and there it is. It runs out as he goes into base. Oh, boy. Oh, Jeju. Ooh, nearly slipped Ridgy. I don't know why Ridgy, he had his side there and he kind of just let the keys go for a second. Squid and One Nut sees the situation that the map was in and just bolts for the kiss. Very good choice. Doors out bottom though with a nice little bomb. The gate was on there, but didn't go for it. They're probably a smart decision considering there's no returns going on. Okay, Ridgy with the RB on flag. Two to beat now. Hold that spot. Beautiful. Gets on the flag, uses the RB. That's the cap. First cap for Spiker Virgin. Nigel coming in off that top bomb. Can't quite make it work. They got four on OD. Strange pushing out midfield. Not really doing anything in particular. Only One Nut. Is he looking off the bottom left corner here? It's on. Like, it's there. Didn't quite hit it. It was on for half a second. But whoever was on OD kind of rolled around while he hesitated. There will be no political arguments in my Twitch chat, otherwise Rupert Murdoch's going to murder Tag Pro. Grab from LBJ. A little slip around Ridgy, but the container's safe, I say. I've done a lot of cursing of people tonight. Knight's trying to slip past them, that's not going to happen. One Nut's trying to bolt top, but only a couple seconds left. The gate is held. And that's a 3-1 first half in favor of the ball guys. One cap each to Strage and Ridgy, and I believe the other two were the first two from iTag. Big half from Strange though, 13 returns, 3 pups, 1 cap. It's pretty decent in a chaotic team environment, which I'm sure it was when iTag was lagging out. I wonder if we'll see him in the second half. Strange is, like, surprisingly good at times. Like, not that it's, like, he's bad or anything, but it's, like, you know, he's a pretty happy-go-lucky guy who just, like, plays Tag Pro. And then, like, every now and then, he kind of gets in that zone. And he just goes for it. I swear I did swap. They're telling me I didn't switch the teams properly. I'll trust them on that. But if I spawn into the game and they're on the same sides. Hello, LBJ, are you, like, listening to me through the stream? Cheeky dog, not allowed to listen to my commentary while you're playing. You're gonna get superior comms from the stream and from your team. Alright, ball guys are ready. Let's see, hopefully Spiker Virgin are getting a big pep talk. I'm really disappointed we don't see Lauren in the Spiker Virgin lineup. I definitely think, no Buttercup either tonight. But I definitely feel like the strongest lineup involves Lauren and Buttercup. It's probably Lauren, Buttercup, only one nut, and maybe Nigel. I feel like that's the strongest lineup they have, so it's kind of disappointing that they don't have everyone on here tonight. Yeah, I feel like that would have been a totally different half if they were here. Alright, the teams are ready. Hopefully the fucking logos spawn. I've got it for like one out of all the halves that have happened tonight. I'm real sad. Yes! Nigel's logo looks so good. The Spiker Virgin logo on the map actually looks amazing. So let's go kick off the half with an iTag grab and out through the portal. Defense kind of kept caught sleeping. Zagorath is in as well, by the way, for Spiker Virgin now. I don't think he was in for the first half. Bridgie and iTag playing games in the portals, but they'll both get returned. Nigel out against one. LBJ's got to stay alive, and he does as a... Oh, Nigel! Split Strange and Jeju! First cap for the half of Spiker Virgin. I paused, I saw it unfolded, it happened. One nut, stay alive, and he does. Saves the cap, this might be their half. Jeju's kind of coming in here. The OD is a bit shaky, but so is the blocks. Rigi gets returned. Don't grab nut. Okay, he does. Kind of uncontested. Avoids the kiss from Jeju, who has the flag pro. Kind of murdered in the end. Oh, Strange just gets around Nigel. Probably a little too eager to get the return, and he's out ahead of everyone. Well, I say everyone, but there's a TP lead, so it might as well be. One nut. Stay alive, boy. Nearly slid over the top of iTag, but he can't. 4-2. Zagorath coming in out through the top there. And gets a cap of his own. 3-4. This is a much faster moving half of Transilio. Alright, let's see what 1-Nut chooses to do. Venom bombs back. It's 8 seconds till Pop spawns. You can make him pick between popping and capping. The gate was on there. He wants the mid pop though. Kisses with the tag bro. A tag's got one of his own, so... Ooh, dangerous. Okay, they need to get this return. Oh, what's going on? No, we're... Oh! The bomb comes... That was pretty horrendous. One nut gets out with a rub grab. Jeju gets surrounded in the spikes. It's very messy, Transilio. Shutdown comms. Can they clean off and get the reset? Strange is just parking on that button because the bomb is up and they end up getting it. Yeah, it's one of the things I see like the lower miners players do. They kind of just... I feel like they're too scared that they're going to get juked. And they like drop their contain, like they just run away to get ahead and they drop contain, and that's like worse in the end because you're just letting them out by running away. Jeju here with the TP lead. iTag slips around and returns Rigi. Two of them get through the gate. One nut rides the boost. Can't stay alive though, and that's going to be the fifth cap for the ball guys. Extending back out to this 2-0 lead. iTag's got this bottom bomb. Bounces off Jeju. He just looks content with holding, really. iTag knows that when they don't have a... You can just bait them out and wait for something silly to happen. They get the shutdown. Good block from Strange allows Jeju to get out top here. Bridgie's kind of just sitting in no man's land with no one around him as the pup spawn. You get the RB because of it. Threaten Strange Cloud. Oh, and he gets the return off the portal. Bridgie, you beast. What the hell was that? Oh, read him like a book. That was dirty. 4-5. One cap game again. Jeju boosting all the way back. Dangerous move, but it works out in the end. No, Knight shuts him down. iTag gets the other shutdown. Good anti from One Nut. Might give Ridgie an attempt here, but there's 3 OD. Hard to see them slipping up, especially when iTag's there. Pups are gonna spawn here, so let's see if Nigel can put some pressure out. Jeju was in a good spot though to receive that little bomb. Slowed Nigel down. I tag might get 2 pups for free if they hold this OD. Gets the tag pro and he's gonna go back and get the RB. Probably a bit of a risky move in all honesty. I guess I had 3 OD, it's probably the right choice. I just see the tag pro and I'm like, go get a grub. Small brain plays. Anyways, One Nut, stay alive. Ooh, LBJ for half a second might have had the boost onto him. And I tag. The recipient of a free double return. He's probably gonna get 10D just for that. Oh, beautiful boost from Strange. I think he could see the blocks there, but he read it well. Didn't roll around, just bounced off the wall very nicely. 6-4 for ball guys. Ridgie's waiting for the pup, but he doesn't know that it's after mid. One Nut should win the mid pup. It's an RB. Nigel's in position for the bottom one. Gets the juice. Ridgie dies. Here we go. I can feel a cap coming up if Nigel can get this solo. One Nut's being patient. Gets his own return. There is no anti, however. Oh, iTag messes the boost up a little. Even threatens the kiss, but chooses not to. Like the selfish player he is. Bring it in, son. Jeju trying to block 2 people here. He's expired the boost, though. Nothing for iTag to play with. Just gets around with a regrab anyways. Get around Zagorath and he does. Nigel just boosts ahead. Right, nothing's gonna happen. They're just gonna look for pups. Yes, One Nut's got the macros in. I like to see it. Strange coming in straight through the bottom. Ooh, they were sleeping, but that's good comms from somebody to pull that one out. 7-4 for ball guys. What? Sorry, I looked away from the screen for half a second. LBJ was making everyone look silly. Luckily, it wasn't a cap and no hype comms were missed. Gets around Nigel though. Doesn't want to be ahead of him. Jukes back and gets returned on the boost. Jeju and Nigel in a little step off. But Jeju just sprints for the bomb and playing time. Getting those pops. Oh, Ridgie wins the TP. Jeju as well. They got 2 TPs though. One Nut gets returned. So, 2 TPs. Okay, he's just kissing. Very well done. Game is not over. That being said, it is the second half. They need to get caps quickly. I won't lie, I forgot it was the second half when I first said that. Bridgie's got the bomb. No, I can't quite connect on straight. Blocked out by the defenders. Probably instinctually, he's got a thing to go through the portal. One nut though, he's out ahead of a couple. Jeju's got flag side though, it was a very good ID. He wasn't in that spot, it's a cap. Every day of the week. But now he's getting a chance of his own. He's just got Richie to beat. LBJ's holding him straight. Oh, the RB spawns. Oh, the portal. Well done, Nigel. Stays alive just long enough. Bit unlucky there for Jeju. He was moving in the direction of the RB and he pulled out just as it spawned. Jeju, nice return there. And with 23 seconds left, Strange Cloud might have the last attempt depending on how quickly he takes it. I tag with a good block on Zagorath. Pushes down LBJ, but the grab saves it just in time as Zagorath comes out ahead. Returned by iTag. A good block from iTag as well to let Jeju get out through the button. And a last second cap to bring it to 8 for the first half. Ball guys. Oh, second half, sorry. Ball guys looking dominant there. And they'll take map 1. Transilio TP. 3 caps to Strange Cloud, 2 to Jeju, none to iTag. 8 pups to iTag, no wonder he's on the top of the scoreboard. 5 to Jeju. 18 to 9, all up in the pup department. 26 tags to iTag, okay, so he did play D on that half, I don't know. He said he'd played on one of the maps. He wants 10-0 and 10-D, he's a fucking selfish boy, this guy. Oh, what did that game end at? It's 10 something, right? Still can tell me the final score and I'll pop it on the scoreboard. Oh, that's right. Yeah, 4-8. Cheers, Bill. So was that? It was a 5-3? Oh, I'm putting these scores in the wrong spot. 5-3, second half. All right, the teams are ready already. Bloody hell, they're zooming through. Do I get my pretty little logos? Yeah, I am losing my voice actually. I'm not even getting the map to load. Okay, come on. Another refresh.
3, 2.
Another one. Alright, no logos. Life is sad. Voice is gone. I thought this beer would help soothe my throat, but it's made commentating easier. Jeju sneaking out straight away. Ball guys, I think they started both games with some very quick caps, maybe every single half. iTag trying to come in with a little bounce, nearly worked. Unusual route. Jadam's a very different map, at least. In terms of how they got to contain, it's very unlike other maps with these weird half-split lanes as iTag comes around the back. I'm going to be very interested to see how Spike of Virgin deal with this because I feel like we saw when Bright's team came down here in Miners, really made the Miners teams look silly. Just with how much you can hold and get big re-grab trains. Oh, Jeju slips around one nut. But the grab from Nigel saved the day. I iTag, staying alive, using the bomb. Bounce off the wall, a beautiful boost block from LBJ, and iTag did have the line there for half a second. Didn't trust his juke around Zagarath, though. And now they have Anti, but they're pushing way too far up there. iTag sacrifices himself to the gods. Oh, boy. To return for cap situation, Strange Cloud does stay alive. So already looks a little bit more frantic, even on both teams. OBJ's got a line out left here. Strange Cloud's got a half decent block going on. Jage will get the TP. It's two TPs here. iTag and Jage. You want to see it? There's a Flaccid coming in from Nigel there. Let Zagarath expire the boost, and the other Flaccid comes in. And against two TPs, it's kind of hard to stop that there, and they play it pretty well there from iTag and Jeju, so credit to them. Unlucky, the Tag Pro expires and he Flaccids, but iTag gets a beautiful handoff. Maybe ended up for the best there, that the Tag Pro didn't give him a bounce out. One Nut kind of just sitting here patiently while Jeju does the dirty juking. LBJ does get that solo though, as I said it. Alright, let's see if they can keep it in here. Zagarath needs to find a way into base. Jeju is going to hold this Anti, or he's looking for the pup. He might get it too. No, Rigi gets there in time. There's two TPs now on the side of Spike Virgin. Okay, they're just killing everyone. They didn't go to the corner. Two TPs are next to Zagarath. And iTag boosts unluckily into One Nut, who steams up through blue. And they might even get a second here. Nigel can't hit the boost correctly. And that's Jeju ahead of four. Ooh, it's unlucky. That's 4-1 there. Probably pretty averagely played. Not really much luck to do with it. Really. Flaccid comes down. One Nut playing boostery. Had a two here. But they got a diamond OD formation. Hard to break. The iTag will eventually end up with that return. Ooh. Gets the tag per and dies. Now JG's got a TP. Ridgie's got to pull off some magic here. And he does avoid Strange Cloud for the time being, but. Good contain from Jeju. Fifth cap for the ball, guys. Honestly, does it feel like Spike Virgin playing too bad in the middle of this game? There's been a lot of caps coming from Tag Pros. On both sides, to be honest. Both sides seem...
Listen in.
A little unfamiliar. I don't really feel like doing listening. Anyways, Ridgie out to the right. Gonna do a little cheeky, little 1v1. Gets around Strange, but LBJ finally shuts that down. LBJ is gonna be out here. Can't get past the OD. Well done, Ridgie. Jeju wanted the pup, but can't quite get it. Strange will get the RB anyways. Oh, Jeju just ends out head. Yeah, the pups are the number one cause of these caps, even if it's not the actual power-ups themselves and it's just baiting people away from where they need to be. Couple Flaccids, but Nigel gets out safely, and a bomb from Zagarath puts him in a lot of safety. Nigel's kind of just content to do big fat circles of the map. Big Jardim energies. iTag's got this team boost to deal with. There's only two of them here. He's probably waiting too long, but makes it happen perfectly timed. Good patience. I'd have sent that a long time ago, but iTag knows better. Oh, now Jeju's got a chance. Strange wants the pup instead, though. Zagarath will win himself at TP. Let's see if he can combine with Nige. Bomb's going to make things a little hairy for them, but let's see how they manage it. Not very well. Zagrath and Reggie do finally link up, but they have the Juke Juice again on the tail. I don't know, Reggie, good boost there to stay alive. But nothing coming from the tag pro. Oh, I did notice the Brazil is up. Big bad Brazil. Hey, do we know if the other game has finished yet? It'd be the Rich Gang game. I'm assuming since Bumby decided to come into the stream channel, it's finished. Monty's first game in OCE Miners would have been fun to see. I reckon that team probably would have done well. I don't think they had demo tonight. Fourth, better than last. Bit of circle jardim. Strange Cloud tries to step Zagorath and just kind of diffuses his RB pointlessly. iTag will take this opportunity to come off the back and get another cap. Has anyone ever gotten 10-0 and 10-D before in 1 week of Tag Pro? iTag might do it. 16-1 to Rich Gang on Trans. Not surprising, to be quite honest. ...15-9 on Jardim. Bloody hell. Slaughter. This game could be going that way. iTag off the 45. Well done. That was tight. That was tight. That was a very swellless of him. Jeju gets a nice little... I guess little bounce with a spin, but iTag gets in his way. Can't have other people on his team having nice caps. Oh, one flaccid here. Jeju runs the team boost. And get... Oh, I thought he had that. Not quite. I'll get away by the skin of their teeth here. Spike of Virgin. Not quite yet double digited. But it might be coming. Monty's the only person who can take out iTag. My team beat him and I wasn't even playing. Reggie though. Not enough to stay alive. Nigel could come in though. Strange gets out against Reggie, but runs into LBJ. Second cap coming on the board for Spiker Virgin. There are signs of life. LBJ though, slipping around Reggie in one nut. There is life, it's probably not too intelligent. And the blocks come in. That's the 10th cap for Ball Guys. This is the slaughter we envisioned. And iTag, once again, gets out. It's a very similar story. Last capping opportunity. Let's see if they play some anti here. iTag's probably screaming for it. Jeju puts it on and he gets around Nigel. 11 caps. Surely iTag's got like 6 or 7 at least. 7 caps, 10 returns, 3 pops. Jeez. 2 minutes, 28 hold. That is a big half. Jeju, 3 caps, 4 pops. He had a good half as well, Jeju. Probably would have had a couple more if it weren't for... just unluckily running into people at times. But that's a very brutal half of Tag Pro. It's always annoying when these things go into such high scores. I can't do the can't put the scores on properly on Tag Pro. You get the future group. Nigel, if you ever go back and watch this VOD, you probably won't because you're getting slaughtered, but if you do, please allow us to put as many caps as we need. What was that? 11-2, bloody hell. You got the. Alright, the teams are ready. Let's get this going. So, an 11-2 first half, and whatever happens in this half, just add it on top. Give me the pretty logos again, you dog. I'm never gonna get it, am I?
3, 2.
Would be nice if the script was a little more consistent. Yeah, second half. JJ gonna boost up from the bottom and probably get promptly straight out ahead of three. If LBJ can get the shutdown, that's a cap. Oh, one nut does the job. Not enough. JJ one flag tile as it comes in. I think they've started off every half with a cap within the first 15 seconds, the ball guys. And it really sets the tone for what's going to happen in this game. LBJ kind of sitting around the side. Boost spawns on someone, gets them into a spike, but the bomb unable to bring the cap in. But a couple flashes should allow iTag to come around the back. And that's his 8th cap for the map. Only one nut though. He'll get one himself as well. Counter cap. Pops are gonna spawn here. Ball guys first to him. Tag Piranda Duke Juice. Oh, but one nut's making them look very silly. I tag. What was that boost? Oh. He needed some karma. Do bad things to people by destroying them in tag pro. You boost into a couple spikes. Alright, there we go. That's a reset for Spike of Virgin. Hopefully they can be like up on net caps at the end of the half. But as I say that, Jeju doesn't get out. Probably had that if he didn't hesitate his line to the right. iTag will get out though to the left. Has the team boost to play with. Just Nigel to beat. Cubs around the back. Very well read, and they're going to get the next two pups. So I think they've got every pup of this half so far. Yubby's defused. Tag Pro. Not that useful. iTag's going to rush up here. Strange is going to run out soon, so maybe he just gets the grab. Ooh, nearly a good Sui to keep it alive. But not enough. Forgive me if you're hearing my fucking bodily burps. Jeju, slick little boost underneath. One that's probably not going to get soloed on Jardim. He's even trying to look for that flag tile at any moment possible. Pups are spawning. Ball guys, gonna win both of them once again. That's 6-0 this half. They're just first to the wall and winning the pups. Jeju surely is gonna lead to the corner. Yeah, Strange knows he wants it. And there it is, 4th cap. Cheers for the follow, Nuke. Big guy Stainby on the top, and Ooh, I tag not quick enough with the juke juice. Is denied by one nut. So some anti from my tag, and we got some flag and base. A beautiful thing in the miner's ecosystem. OBJ though. Hits that corner. He's going to be coming down the right side, but the bomb slows him down. They want these pups again. Oh, and LBJ wins the right one as well. They're keeping the perfect pup streak alive. iTag clutchly grabs there, otherwise Richie probably would have had it. He was on flag tile before Jeju stopped him. And, oh, Jeju probably should have gone under there. That would have been a cap. But LBJ is storming in. Yeah, that was four to beat. Any hope of the cap is gone. We're just gonna be doing see a bit of circle work. It's like a mirror. Oh, Dawes misses the boost, but Ruggie in the right spot to dodge him into it. Second cap there for Spiker Virgin. I guess that was no pressure. Would have had it even if Ruggie wasn't there. One nut with a weird little boost off the teammate. They want these pups again. Spiker Virgin might get their first pop here. One nut. Can't get past. Dawes will pick up one, but it's an RB. Poor fellow. Beautiful snipe by Strange. Good bomb from Dawes. Pushes Nigel into the return there. But the kills were the damage that was done. And iTag will walk that one in for the fifth cap for the ball guys. I think iTag is definitely going to be looking for double digits in both halves for his team. He wants that 20 on the scoreboard, I reckon. I guess they don't have to double digit to get the 20. iTag's going to be getting another one. Let's see how many caps is on. 7 in the first half. 3 in the second. He's on 10 caps for Jardim. He's a tag pro lead here. Let's see if they can make it work. They got 2 chasing. They're coming off reef for it. Very well comp. Strange is just holding. He's just holding my tag down. Oh, good job, Strange. I'd like to think that was on purpose. Bless your soul. Oh boy. Nigel's gonna be running it in. Nah, Great White Shark is there to say no cap for you, mate. Oh. Sad times. Kiss comes through. Oh, one not nearly hits the corner with that bomb. It's in the right spot though to stop that cap. Strange kind of hesitating, probably could have challenged. There's only 2 on OD there, but he's probably thinking about pops. They're like, look, we can't let them get more than one pop. And JG wins the tag pro, and once again they win an RB only on the side of Spiker Virgin. Well done by laid back juke there to stop the 2v1 grab and get the cap comes in, and another double cap. Soundbite hasn't even finished by the time the second cap comes in. Big Jardim moments. Dawes has a chance here. Everyone's going on moving around rapidly for some reason. Very unsettled. Ball guys are like, what's up, OD? We just score caps all day. They got a nice triangle there around the flag, so they look pretty secure. Attack gonna be out right here ahead of 2. No return on Ruggie though. Ooh, they get the RB on flag. Well navigated. Instantly defuses. He challenges Nigel though. Oh, JJ kind of just pumping LPJ out of his juke. They're playing for Caps. Individually. Oh, that's one faucet. That'll let ITAG come in. Eighth cap of the half. They're going to be one away from the big 20 bomb. And with 1 minute left, it is looking likely. Bomb return across the map from Strange Cloud, if you don't mind yourself. Jesus. Eiju's kind of just doing whatever the hell he feels like as the pup spawn. Strange in a bit of a weird spot for it. One Nut's going to bully him into that spike. He's going to win that one. Eiju wins the pup. Couple spikes, but business as usual when I tag. Gets on the flag. Do it, LBJ. Nah, he's missed. Ooh, almost a very good bomb there from Doors, but not quite enough in the end. Tag taking these boosts in a weird way. He's got 17 seconds if he wants that 20 bomb. Gets the boost as it spawns. One Nut holding underneath, and the anti from Regi is probably going to be the end of the half. One Nut will get himself a cap as well here. In the dying seconds, that's a 3-8 second half in favor of the ball guys, and that's the 2-0 sweep coming into them. Five caps for, I'd say, only two pups this half, but, you know, we'll forgive him for that. Eiju, six pups. He also had a quietly monster game. I think he pulled himself five caps in the previous one. This was a big week for the ball guys. They're just 2-0 sweeping everyone below them. Like, it's fun. So, yeah, brutal half. Brutal game. Brutal week. If I can get one of the captains to come in. Eight three, wasn't it? I believe. Where are you, Mr. ITAG, bro? I'm just going to keep dragging him until he realizes what's going on. Forever never seems that long until you're grown. And notice that the day-by-day ruler can't be too wrong. Miss Jackson, my intentions were good. I'm sorry for all I'm doing to you, ITAG. Thank you. You realized what was going on.
I figured it's either you or Regi was moving me, but I remember that Regi can't move.
Well, you had a massive two games. Well, actually, it was only one game that was massive, but I mean, your team stand—they stood up pretty well when you disconnected in the start of the game. Do you want to enlighten us as to what was going on there?
I don't even know what happened. I was just like holding the button, and then I see whoever had flag just kind of drift off to the right. I'm like, that doesn't look natural. And then everyone started going to the right. I'm like, oh fuck. And no, supposedly, like, I'm talking to Strange and LBJ. They said that it didn't look like I disconnected because I was just holding the button still or something. I was like next to the button.
Yeah. And yeah, so, yeah. It was obvious for a bit you were lagging. You tried to fix it, I think. And then, well, the call came to bring Squid in. How do you feel Squidder went and just the whole team in general when you weren't playing?
I was happy with it.
It was pretty close when you came in. Well, when dropped out, sorry.
I think we just couldn't really get any resets as that when I wasn't in there. And I know we kind of lacked that ability later on as well, even when I was playing. But sometimes we just like miss a chance to get a reset, slow down the game, and give ourselves a chance to like get pups. Because we got absolutely destroyed on pups on Transilio. Like the first half was 18-9 or something.
It was, yes. Yeah, that and was a good one.
It was like crazy. And I think like I just reinstated, was like, but be happy that we're in front, but just kind of got done pretty badly on pups. But I was happy with how Squidder did. I talked to him throughout the week about how I want him to play. So yeah.
As in like you gave him advice and you reckon he followed up pretty well on it?
Yeah. He asked a couple of questions too, and I gave him the best answer that I think I could. Probably don't know if it was the right one, but
so, you know. A personal question. Are you looking for the 10-0 and 10-D or something? Like, what's going on here?
Are we this the same week? Moments?
Why are we seeing iTag on D in these games? Sometimes iTag. What's going on here?
What do you mean? Because of the second half of trans?
Yeah, it's second half.
Because I played over that half, I can assure you.
I thought you did, but like I wasn't sure. Like, you know, when I'm solo comming, I'm just watching the game. I'm not really watching too much. But I saw you with what 20 returns,
yeah. Or something. Like, right. End of the half, I'm like, wait, hold on. I don't remember like not capping, but the whole returns bit, I was like, wait, what?
And then Jardim was a massive blowout. Do you think you guys kind of just understood Jardim better than Transilio? Or do you think maybe it was a Spike of Virgin thing? What do you reckon was going on there?
We were good at capitalizing on mistakes that they made. And there were definitely opportunities where they'd like slip contain and we were just able to like get out on one side and then get a re-grab train going. I think the lack of anti from them kind of killed them. In the long term, I suppose.
Well, anything you want to say to the stream? Otherwise, I might just let the replays roll and then finish it.
Hi, chat. Also, thanks for putting up with me for 40 minutes. Wait, not 40 minutes, 80 minutes.
Oh, yeah, you got the double game. How was Majors on a personal note?
It was all right, I think. I don't know. Trans, I felt like I played all right. And Jardim, I can't contain on Jardim for the life of me. But I got some sick caps. That's the important thing. The last one was especially sick.
You got a pretty nice one, I remember, at the start of one of the halves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got Night Cheat, by the way.
BBC showed up all right. You guys will... We'll get there.
Yeah, I think as a team we were good for like three quarters of the game, and then that one quarter we would just like slip off, and that's when they'd get all these caps in and we just couldn't drag ourselves back from it.
Yeah, I definitely think that's a pretty good assessment on what happened.
Yeah. Hey,
thanks.
Hey, Nigel.
Hello.
What was the situation, Nigel? No Lauren, no Buttercup, he's unable to rock up this week.
Yeah, they both notified me during the week that they couldn't attend tonight for various reasons.
That's unfortunate.
But it did allow us to debut the one, the only one nut, who's actually goated. That's insane. I'd go as far as saying that he would be one of the better players going around in minors if he actually had cons. But even without cons, he's actually insane. Like, I can't even begin to explain how good that guy played.
He's been showing people up in TPM, doing a lot of just really solid stuff in general.
Yeah, I'm the worst captain in the history of LTPA, so I don't do a lot. I'm not around a lot, but I've been hearing good things about Nut. So when I saw that we were actually given him in our free agency, I was like, this is a blessing. And as it so happened, no Buttercup, no Lauren. So yeah, Nut came in, was killing it, and I'm sad for him that we couldn't do better for him, because we it's pretty average most of the night. I think we had a few good moments on Transilio, but I think
the game would have been a lot closer, like if you had your full team. Like, it wouldn't have been like Transilio itself was close.
Yeah, I think I was John actually was we were really happy.
Like, yeah, Jardim's one of those maps where inexperienced and new players don't play much. Like, they get lost.
Yeah, it
like,
can get away from you very, very quickly. And that's pretty much what happened. It was a textbook Jardim game where one team was just kind of running it and the other team just trying to stay in it, really.
Yeah. Yeah, I think there's good things to come for the Spike of Virgin side when you can get your players on the park. It'll be... I don't think your team, as other people probably want to believe, is a write-off. Like, I don't believe in that.
I'm still confident that we've got some good games in us, and I still think that we can still sneak into fourth if we stay competitive and hanging games. Because, yeah, obviously Stevie's team's a lot better than it was, but I still think that the translator game showed that we've still got the ability to kind of, you know, challenge teams, keep it tight. And we were playing pretty well for most of that game. So yeah, I think the team's doing really well. They're unfortunate that they have to carry me. That's the burden they face, really. But I'm the biggest liability in my subway. After what I did to, I don't know, I was Jeju and someone on Translator, I should probably retire after that. And
oh, the split?
Disappear. Yeah, the split.
You and I think it was Jeju and Strange. That was a dirty little cat.
Oh, I heard about that. It was like later in the game. It was like after that cap, Jeju or whoever's like, just don't get split this time, okay? I was like, what the fuck happened?
I was like, I'm dead. I'm through. I split them. It was insane. I popped off for a good 15 seconds, I reckon, after that. I couldn't process what happened.
My blood's pumping. Let's go.
Yeah. And I think that got us back to, it was 3-2 at that point as well after I capped. So, and then they got one, I think, 15 seconds later, which is a little deflating. But, yeah, you know, that tag pro works sometimes.
I mean, that Transilio game, even in the second half, was like, I think it was close for a while.
It was. It got away from us, and I think in the last, like, 2 minutes. I think one thing that really hurt us, especially in the set, like, Jarden with the pups, and that's probably been our Achilles heel for a lot of the season. We just don't win enough. And I think, obviously, like, if you don't win pups, that's going to be a disadvantage. But I feel like we've also got extremely unlucky in pup RNG. Like, obviously, if you don't win pups, the other team's going to get pups and thus have a greater chance of getting better pups. But I feel like whenever we lose pups, other teams get tag pros, and on maps like Jarden, they are, like, so powerful. Like, I think there was a string of, like, 3 rounds in a row. I think the right pup was a tag pro. And then we finally got it. It was an RB, and they got our pup, which ended up being a tag pro. And I was like, how can the RNG be this cruel?
Yeah, that Jarden one, when you did start winning pups, it was the RBs. I remember commentating on it. It's pretty unfortunate.
Yeah, it was. I felt like I got RBs, I think, 7-8 times the whole night. Like, I got a Juke Juice once or twice, and I feel like I got, like, one tag pro, if that. But, yeah, I played pretty poorly, that, especially the second half.
Timmy had... Sorry.
No, I was saying, I think I might even consider benching myself in the coming weeks to get the team... to get the team out there, and, you know, because I feel like these guys, I mean, I'm probably done after this season, I think. Like, I'm so washed.
You got Blitz Arena, right?
I'm just retiring so I can focus on my MTC and TPFG.
I was going to say, you're talking to the man who's on the Tag Pro Future group.
Yeah.
Blitz Arena.
You're on a Blitz, right?
That's I'll play Blitz as well.
He's staging a coup.
I've got to find out all the things that Blitz does right.
You got to let
take them back to Tag Pro.
Let the new kids spread their wings.
It's a race to Steam. Like, just because Blitz Arena exists doesn't mean it's going to get big. That's the GG.
I don't understand all this massive simping for Blitz Arena when, like, Tag Pro is doing some good things. We're in a really good spot now. The TBFG is up and about, making changes. I mean, obviously I'm a little bit biased to being part of the group, but I feel like Tag Pro's, I mean, obviously it's like a semi-dead game, but at the same time, the things that are happening, a reason for, like, the Osh community and even, like, the broader Tag Pro community and, like, NA and stuff to be excited about, because things are improving and being worked on. So I think people should be, like, sticking with Tag Pro and kind of having a little faith in the game they've been playing for years and kind of fallen in love with, and not just jumping ship so willy-nilly.
You can't blame players before when, like, nothing was happening, but now that there's actually development going on...
Yeah, agreed.
It's a different ball game.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. All right.
Got a inside question quickly.
Okay.
Tower event, Nige. Any behind the scenes info you can give us?
I don't know how much I can really reveal, but I can confirm the event most likely, I'm going to say, this coming weekend. I can confirm the tower is done. It's been created. I've tested it. I was not very good at it. But it's pretty fun. Some cool new flares.
Saying likely this week or possibly this week?
I believe we're testing it sometime during this week to hopefully get it out by this weekend. Mm-hmm. I believe is the plan. So, I mean, this is birthday, technically birthday month of Tag Pro. So
birthday because, year.
The birthday was like 2 weeks ago, I think, officially. 3 weeks ago. But yeah, it's still technically in birthday month. So I think that's kind of the plan. As long as we get it out. And we haven't had a birthday event, I think, a birthday tower for like a couple of years, I think. So, I think lots to be excited about. And hopefully more event-style things, maybe an Easter one, if I can convince people and get something out.
Well, it is a good time to be a tag pro.
Yeah, get hyped. Season 14 on the horizon too, right?
I'm going to end the stream because I'm done with streaming for the night.
Thank you for streaming all like 2 games tonight by yourself, solo comms, after A ditched you. Play Hell A.
Oh, no, that wasn't A's fault. My software bugged.
You should have just blamed him.
Oh, fucking A, dude. This guy's useless. Can't even talk. What are we having around for? All right, I'm muting them just so I can end the stream because otherwise I'll never get to end it. Cheers for everyone for watching. Yeah, I'm sorry. It was weird. When we were scrimming A earlier, I already had my setup going and it was working. I could hear everyone in the scrim channel. And then as soon as I left to the other stream room, it just fucking stopped. Very weird stuff. But thank you for all the watches and everything and the follows and the lovely community we have. I don't know why I'm still talking. It's because I'm trying to find the stop streaming button. Goodbye.